Root mean square speed. In a steel container with a fixed volume of 45.0 liters, we have 40.0 grams of carbon dioxide, 60.0 grams of nitrogen, and 23.0 grams of an unknown gas. The temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, and the total pressure is 1.77 atmospheres. A. What is the molar mass of the unknown gas? B. We lower the temperature so that the total pressure becomes one-third of the original. What is the root mean square speed of the unknown gas after this drop in temperature? To determine the molar mass of the unknown gas, we need to determine the number of moles present in the container. Since the question gave us the total pressure, we can start by solving the total number of moles with the ideal gas equation. We need to rearrange the formula for number of moles. By dividing the masses of CO2 and N2, each by their known molar mass, we can find the number of moles of each in the container. Here, the addition of the mass of the atoms for the molar mass is shown directly in the equation. We do the same thing for N2. The sum of the moles of the three gases must equal the total quantity of moles in the container. By subtracting the quantities of moles of the two known gases, we obtain the number of moles of the unknown gas. Now we can simply divide the given mass of the gas by the number of moles we just calculated to find its molar mass. We cut the answer down to three significant digits, since all the data in the question had at least three significant digits. We will use this answer to help us solve the next question. In part B, we need to determine the root mean square speed of the unknown gas with the following equation. First, we need to solve for the temperature of our gas after the cooling. We will use this equation. The units with a subscript 1 will designate the data before the drop in temperature, and the subscript 2 for after. The question stated that volume was kept constant during the experiment, so we can eliminate it from our question. We need to rearrange the equation to solve for T2. We could insert the initial pressure and the calculated value for the new pressure, but they will cancel anyways. All that's important is that the pressure is lowered to a third of what it was before. This means that the temperature will simply lower to a third of its original value to lower the pressure to a third. We insert this new temperature value into the root mean square speed equation. Be careful, we need to remember that this equation uses molar masses in kilograms per mole, since it uses SI units. In part A, we found the molar mass to be 112 grams per mole, which gives 0.112 kilograms per mole. The root mean square speed is 149 meters per second. In this course, root mean square speeds should always have values somewhere in the hundreds of meters per second.